Good evening, guys. Emo's pinched my chair again. And, I've had a haircut! Oh, it's all gone! Now it's just this to go, and, I look somewhat tiny instead of scruffy. I've been to Mum's today. I did come careful and you slid off my lap. And I did come home with something, which I'll show you in just a ticket. But that's going to keep me occupied for tomorrow anyway. At least for 10 minutes. Completely slipped my mind of what I was going to say. Do this better without you on my lap. If I can sit at Mum's with a big Labrador dog sitting on my lap having a cuddle, I'm sure I can cope with the cat. Although her little Jack Russell mint, she's limping at the moment. But we're not sure she's actually putting it on for a bit of sympathy, because animals are far from stupid. Or she has actually hurt it in some way, because I've watched her and I can see she's scratched herself perfectly fine with that leg. And we've touched her leg, straightened her leg out, we've done everything and she doesn't even flinch. There's a certain movement which she doesn't like too much, but she doesn't yelp in pain or go to bite us or any form of indication that she's in pain, but she will not put weight on that leg. So I'm thinking she might be playing the sympathy vote to get things. Which apparently can be a trait for Jack Russell's. As well as a Mum did look it up, and they can have a genetic disorder in their knee. So it could even be that. I don't know. I'm not a vet. I'm not an expert. But when you watch her, I am sort of like, is she put it on or has she got a problem there? Or is it a bit of both, maybe? Who knows? Anyway, I had noticed when Mum dropped me off that there's a Range Rover parked on the council office car park. But that was there when Mum picked me up and it hasn't moved, which is odd. Maybe it broke down, maybe someone is seeing someone. I don't know, it could be a number of reasons why it's parked there, but it's not parked properly either, it's parked at an angle. Up against the wall that runs out the front there. But, who knows? I'm actually pretty certain I saw that driving around town via middle-aged man, I'll say. He must have been, I don't know, 40s, 50s, something like that. Yesterday when I was waiting for Mum when she came up town. So it's probably the same one. Maybe it's broken down. Maybe he fell ill. I don't know. Maybe he went into town and fell ill and been taken to hospital. I don't know. It's just unusual, though. We don't often get cars just park randomly like that on the car park. Anyway, I did make a video of me playing some Grand Theft Auto 5, but it wouldn't upload to YouTube, and I think that's because I had some music playing. Because I uploaded two other videos absolutely fine. So, maybe it was detecting the video and, detecting the audio, and that's why it was hanging on the processing point. So I'll do another one, and before I start recording I'll make sure all the radios, well actually I'll go into settings and I'll just turn the radio volume down, that's all, right down so nothing can be heard. I've got a double decker chocolate bar behind me on that shelf and I'm fighting the urge to eat it because Well, I'm diabetic, as you know. It's 10:30 at night. If I eat that now, I'm not doing anything active, so my sugars are going to go through the roof. And I don't feel like waking up regularly during the night to go for a pee. So, as much as it is tempting me behind me, it's going to stay there till tomorrow. On the way to Mum's, we did stop in at the recycling centre, and I just missed out on a bicycle. Someone had already beaten me to it. Oh well, you win some, you lose some. I think he must do car boots or something, because he was in a big van. And technically, they're not supposed to sell things to people like that, because the idea is, you're only supposed to go to the recycling centre if you're going to reuse it yourself. But then again, I can't really complain because I do the same thing. I don't think the boys at the recycling centre really care. But never mind. yeah, a few kids' bikes there again, but I suppose either tomorrow or Tuesday I'm going to have to drag out the lady's Sirocco bike and start rebuilding that and fashioning that into a rideable and usable bicycle. And finish the Saracen off, that would be good, because I'll probably sell that one. Or I'll more than likely sell that one. Turn you around. This whole corner's going to change tomorrow. So if I get a chance and I get some space cleared in here, I'll do we'll start on the bike tomorrow. But that cabinet is going to go there where the bollard is. I haven't decided where the bollard's going to go yet. I might stick it up my own arse because I'm running out of room. But because Mum's had a change around in the lounge, thanks to Stepdad's bright ideas. Stepdad wants a marine fish tank in the lounge, so where this was is now, pardon me. Oh, where this was is now, occupied by a 6-foot marine fish tank. It's not got nothing in it yet, he's only just built the stand to put it on and, put the tank in there, but he's still got to get a lot of the equipment, like all the sump and sump pumps and whatnot. Yeah, this is actually quite heavy, because this top here is, well, as you can see, that's actually quite thick. But I did get it upstairs. It was a bit of a struggle, but I did manage. Well, obviously, otherwise it wouldn't be there. But I'm planning to stick it in here and use it as an extra, display shelf, if you like. And maybe a bit of storage for these. I could tuck those in there. I could probably get two on each, actually. On each of them shelves, or I could find something else to store on them shelves, so I think I will, actually I think I'll leave these on the bottom of this coffee table. So no, I'm not going to be extending this street anymore onto this one. It will, I suppose I could in the future, but I do need storage space more than anything, so I did want to make like a separate display to this anyway. Just for all my construction stuff. So I am getting quite a lot of it, to be honest. Now I'm starting to make my own, so I was thinking of like making a depot of some sort. A construction depot. Or I might just, like I said, use it as a shelf to display things on. I haven't decided yet. I'll worry about getting it in there, but that's heavy itself, so that's going to be a chore to shift that, and I'm going to have to empty it all out. And there's no way I'm shifting that with all those models in there, because they'll roll off the shelves, and they'll get broken, and yeah. So, that's a job for tomorrow. Have a bit of a tidy up in here. I could at least get that off the floor. so I don't go breaking the wall again. No, the wall is mostly broke in one whole chunk anyway, so that's a bonus. I'm gonna take this friggin' thing down later out of the way. Right. Snowplow came yesterday, I think I mentioned that in the other video. See, if that TV cabinet was actually taller, I'd have sat up this corner and put all one of each of my consoles on each of the four shelves, but that's not tall enough, it's too low. It'd be alright if I had a TV on a taller stand or something, but that'll do. That'll go in here, hopefully. Might have to nudge the coffee table along a little bit, but... excuse me. Right. Yeah, I was actually toying with the idea of going for a little stroll later. That's all. And I think as I'm expanding, well, I don't know, I was thinking of adding a light underneath this shelf like I have there, as I was expanding this way, but to be honest, I think the main light is bright enough. Right. Yeah, that can go in the bin. Not no use for that. That was quite a disappointment taking that apart. Something else to take apart, but I haven't got anything. I like taking things apart like that and seeing what sort of gubbins are on the inside that make it tick. May not know what everything on it does, but after watching a bunch of YouTube videos, I've got a rough idea at least, you know. But, yeah, I've still got that job to do, so I've got these boards to strip. I could do that for a video, couldn't I? I could strip these boards out for parts. I've got a funny feeling we're going to get a frost tonight, because it's feeling rather cold. Is that or it's just because I've got no hair? I don't know why Mum didn't use a comb and for the hair clippers. It's because they haven't got any for those. I don't think the ones I've got for my clippers will fit, because my clippers are blunt. They barely cut this. That's a job for tomorrow as well, get rid of this. In here, I was actually thinking of having a bit of a change around, turning the bed around so instead of it sitting along this wall, it runs along that wall, and put the TV and everything over here, just for a change. More than anything, but then again, if I do that, I won't get to those computers, would I? Because I think that bed... Oh, actually, that might be a tight squeeze, there might be a little bit of a gap. I don't know. Well, that's a big chore as well, because I've got to empty everything out from under the bed before I move it, and from down there. And, I don't know. If I decide to do that, I doubt that'll be tomorrow. Yeah. Forgot. I'll charge that up. Turn. Oh, do the cat tray. That needs doing. That's a task for tomorrow. I'm just going to have to nudge that out of the way. I need to get to the bathroom. I need to do it quietly because it is late at night. So I'm going to do that now before it gets later. Because I do need to use the bathroom as well. I'll come back a little bit later. I'm sure I can think of something to add, talk about, do, you know, pick my nose or something. I'll think of something. Oh, my arms are killing me. Perhaps it wasn't a good idea dragging that can't actually see it, can you? I'm using the old camera because I've got my batteries charged for the other one. Don't think dragging that upstairs on my own was a good idea. I've killed both arms. Anyway, I went for a little nightly walk, like I normally do. Look what I found. And look what I found. Does it work? Not a friggin' clue. Is it full of cobwebs and dust and other shit? Yes, it is. Am I looking forward to perhaps having to open it up and check to see if there's anything inside that needs to be cleaned out? No, I'm not. I'm just clearing some space up here. Because this, actually, for a CRT, is pretty low. Right, so what's the brand we've got? JBT. DC, AC, and something in the middle, I'm not sure, but you can actually have it on AC or DC. That is a DC plug, I assume that would be 12 volt DC. So I'm guessing you could use it in a... Thermat, this thing is old. It's been in sunlight as well, because it's severely yellowed. Look at this. That's the tuner. This doesn't actually have channels, I don't think. I think that is just the tuner. Just plug it in and tune it to a channel. There is no channel buttons. This is all the contrast controls and whatnot. Yeah, some cobwebs on this. It's got the age old. I love it. I haven't seen one of them hair heels in ages. I actually only got this, or took it, because if it worked, it would be ideal to use for my old computers. I'm not too fussed about the yellowing. I know the plastic is still strong. If there is plastic, that could be Bakelite, actually, I'm not sure. I might be able to bleach it back to its original colour. Don't know if I dare turn it on. I am. However, find what I'm looking for without standing on the cat because he's getting in the way. I just want a cloth, an old cloth. Oh, I'm going to have to do that tray. It's getting a bit smelly. I don't know what I'm looking for. I just can't find what I'm looking for. Ah, I forgot to have a shower as well because I had my hair cut. Have this. My rags have disappeared. All the rags I used to clean bicycles and whatnot seem to have vanished. Lots of polish. Right. I must have an old cloth somewhere. I don't want to use a tea cloth. Nope. Got anything under here? Potatoes I'd forgotten about. That have gone soft and started to sprout, so I don't think this. Forgot I had those. No, I don't even have any rags under here. What the fluff have I done with them? Could be in here somewhere. In the place I'm likely to throw them. You damn well there'd be one in there somewhere. Right. Let's get some of this. Dust and shite off of this, shall we? Ooh, look. Found a screen. Marks on the screen where he's been knocked about. I might have to watch some of B. Bishop's videos on getting white casings back to white. Although that would require stripping this whole thing out, I think. So I'm not overly keen on that idea. Yeah, it's been stored somewhere damp as well. Whee! Right. Well, that's the front side done. Turn it around. Ah. There's no plug. Why does this have a tube hanging out the back? Oh. It's obviously for the, circular antenna. I will leave that on there just for the novelty of it. Ooh, we have an earth. I don't think this would need to be earthed. Well, I couldn't even plug it in tonight if I wanted to see if it worked, because there's no plug. Not to worry. Probably things living inside this. So I really am not looking forward to having to open it up. I think it's a good idea if I do open it up before I turn it on. You know, just to make sure there's no dirt or dust or anything that's gonna short something out and start a fire and lots of fireworks. But I'll have the vacuum cleaner at the ready. I can't even see any screws actually. Oh, yeah, I found two. There's four, I think. Two under the carry handle and one on each corner. Two pipes coming in. No. Some kind of a... I don't know what that is. There's this as well, and there's some other things to adjust and all. Knowing my luck, I've probably rescued an old item that doesn't work. Actually, to be honest, I might just find a flashlight. I can see quite clearly in here, and... No, I don't think I will need to take this apart, to be honest. That looks pretty damn clean in there. Yeah. Sweet. Okay, so our job for tomorrow will be to clean it. I was actually thinking 80s, but I don't think this is, and this is likely black and white. I'm guessing, though. I can't see it being anything better. I actually feel like putting a plug on it now and plugging it in to see if it does work. Yeah, fuck it, why not? I'll do that, so. Alright then, I'm going to go find a plug, put the plug on, and, we'll see if we go back. Okay, this will be the last part for this video. I went for a little walk earlier, just around the block, and I walked past this area where there's a bunch of dumpsters, or wheelie bins, as we call them here, and I've got a bunch of DVDs in a bag, and some VHS tapes. I don't want those, I'll go in the bin. But I think the score was that. Now, I did have to clean a lot of dust and crap off of it. I have fitted a plug. I have tested it, but I'm not going to tell you the outcome of the test in this video. You can, you'll have to wait till the next video. I'm just being mean. To go through this, this is a JBT portable TV. It's got contrast and brightness switches, volume. That's turned down. And it's got the power switch here. Now, middle is off, and you've got DC there, AC there. So it's just basically, if you've got it plugged into the mains, it'll just be on, off. The DC jack is on here, but it doesn't actually say what the voltage is in. I would presume 12 volt, but I haven't checked any of the information on the back yet. In fact, because it's not a very heavy TV, let's just turn it around, turn the spot on, and we'll have a look. Does it actually say it? May I even say it's got the old circular antenna, which is a bit rusty. It's been years since I've seen one of those. No, it's just got a load of caution on the back. A couple of... Ah! That's what that is. There's nothing on the bottom. But I wondered what this was. I thought that was a weird, there's a pipe coming out of there, but it's going on the vertical hold. So it's a vertical hold adjustment, horizontal hold adjustment, V-line, and V height. Ah, that's what all that is. It's just the adjustments. I shouldn't have to adjust those if it works. Does it work? I'm not telling. I want to do a separate video on this. But yeah. Oh, alright, I'll tell you, it does work, but I will be doing a separate video on this tomorrow. Couldn't leave you in suspense. What I'm going to do with this is put it in the bedroom with the old Commodore and Amstrad and whatnot. The other thing with this one is it doesn't have channel select. The only way to change the channel is to move the tuner dial. Which really, couldn't really use it on modern digital stuff, because I suppose you could if you could get a Freeview box with the standard coaxial jack on it, then you could still use it, but other than that, there ain't a lot of not a lot of use on this unless you've got old computers like I've got, which will probably work better through that. I think, without trying to do a bit of research, I would estimate this is about a 1970s TV, probably late, mid to late, because this power cable has got the more modern colour code in it, the brown, blue and green and yellow. Which I think, if I remember correctly, came out in the 70s. This is a grey cable, which I know from experience is quite common on items from the 70s, so I'm going to guess that this is 70s. It looks too old. Yeah, the plastic's gone yellow, but it's meant for a white colour. Typical of this plastic. I mean, it actually does work. I don't know if all three of the computers work on the same frequency, but it'd be great if they did, then I could just leave that where it is, but we'll find out. I've actually realised I've got quite a few of old items. You know, I've got the old rare VCR down there with the double-sided videotape. I've got the Philco valve radio. I've got the Dragon 32 computer up there, sitting on top of a 1989 Zenith Data Systems laptop. I've got the Pioneer audio amp, which I think is 80s. I've got that. I've got three PCs in the bedroom. I've got my little Casio calculator up here, which I do still use. I love this thing. My little Casio. Personal M1, the electronic calculator, 1979, because I researched that one. I've actually got two old calculators, because I've got another Casio here. Which also works. This one's got the LCD display. This one's a bit newer. I don't know how newer. I haven't actually bothered to research this one. But, let's take triple A's or double A's or something. I can't remember. Double A's. Can't get the cover back on one-handed. They both take double A's, these Casios. I have actually got another one somewhere. I've got a Scientific one. It was over there somewhere. I'll find it later. Unless I throw it back over here. It's around here somewhere. I was trying to think what else. I'm sure I've got some more classic tech. Oh, I've got the Sega Mega Drive console. I've sort of got a museum going. Oh, I've got the 1970s / 80s radio tape player in the bedroom. Forgotten about that till just now. I could probably set up a whole room with just old stuff in it. I haven't got a VCR from the 80s though. I do have a black one underneath the bed, but I need to pull that black one out because I want to see what the picture's actually like. And to see if it is actually black and white, which I'm fairly certain it will be. But I would presume the DC is 12 volt. Because it's a portable TV, so I'd assume that would be designed to be used in a caravan. So again, I would presume, as caravans are 12 volt, that's what that would be for. Nope, just connected 12 volt cable on there. Probably came with the cable in the box when it was new. Oh, it's not JBT, it's JBI. That's an I. Aye, aye. Yeah. Anyway, it's nearly 3 o'clock in the morning. I've been talking to a friend, so I'm going to head to bed. So, thanks for watching, and if you liked the video, hit the like button. Stay tuned for the video I'll do on the TV after I've got that cabinet set up that I dragged upstairs yesterday. Yeah, it would be yesterday now. Today is now Monday. Monday the 11th. I'm actually hurting all over from dragging that upstairs. My arms were hurting alone, and now I've got pain going right across here. So, yeah. Me and my bright ideas, and my stubbornness as well. Anyway. If you want to see more videos, feel free to subscribe. And we'll talk to you again soon. Bye.